You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at the visual alert pattern using custom vision. It's pretty cool. We have devices and we have AI. You're not going to want to miss it. Make sure you take a look. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk about something called custom vision, and we have a lot of contraptions here, so I'm super excited. Why don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, so I'm Anna Roth. I'm a senior pro... Oh, I just got promoted.
Oh, congratulations. Boom. We should keep that in.
Oh,
or should
no.
we start again? What are you now?
A principal program manager.
Yeah!
Computer vision team. Our team supports cognitive services.
Fantastic. So tell us what computer vision is, and then maybe custom vision, and then let's get into what we're going to do today.
Absolutely. So computer vision is like what it sounds like. It's machines that can see things, right? So technologies that let you take in a visual input and get out some kind of structured data. Mm-hmm. That tells you about what's going on kind of in the scene.
Fantastic.
Custom vision is a tool. It's one of our cognitive services that makes it really easy to build your own customized computer vision models. So you can build an image classifier, an object detector to recognize the things that you care about.
Fantastic. And so now, like, for me, this is super cool because I'm a vision person. It's what I've been specializing in recently. So what are you showing us today? Something about alerts, if I get this.
Absolutely. So we have seen a lot of folks using this kind of fun new pattern where they're wanting to build kind of classifiers or kind of alerts for their own cameras. So let's say, you know, you have a camera somewhere and you want to know every time a truck shows up.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, we have a great customer, Mentor, who has a camera sitting over a river. They're doing some environmental processing. And so you want to have like a very simple classifier that just says, is this thing that I care about in the frame? But it turns out these are really easy to build.
Well, are we building one today?
That's right. We're going to actually show how you can do that.
So before we get into that, let's explain what all these contraptions are. What is this?
So this is a Qualcomm Dragon Board. It's an IoT device. You know, get it online.
Fantastic. And it's hooked up to a camera, correct?
That's right. So we have this hooked up to a camera right here. And what we want to do today is basically imagine that I want to know if like a delivery truck, or I guess in this case a news truck,
right,
is showing up in front of my, you know, like my like where I work.
Right, like if a little tiny truck shows up at your work, we want to know right away.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
And so it's that simple. And so what I'm going to do now, this device is hooked up with Azure IoT Hub. And so I'm going to send a message to this device. That says enter learning mode. And so basically what that's doing is now we're starting to capture images from this device. So I'm going to move this truck around so we have a couple of different angles here, a little more detail. We want some images with the truck. So if the truck has shown up, we also want some without, right? So we want some negative examples here of what things might look like. I'm even going to walk around here when we have other stuff going on in the camera that isn't the truck.
And the number below is just how many pictures have been uploaded.
Yeah, we're just sending pictures up to Custom Vision service.
Fantastic.
So as a cognitive service, Custom Vision is a cloud service. It's running in Azure.
Cool.
And so these images are being sent using the Custom Vision APIs up to Azure. So now I'm going to actually switch. Yes. Switch here to my laptop. And so we can actually go into Custom Vision service. So here I have Custom Vision, and I'm going to refresh here to see the images that I just sent up to Custom Vision service. And so this is a web portal. It's optional. You can do everything using the APIs if that's how you want to do it, but it's a little easier to demo if we use the customvision.ai site. And so you can see here I've uploaded a bunch of images. I have a truck, and I have sort of images without truck. So I'm going to go and annotate these images and say, well, these are the truck. Take a second here. Let's give some examples.
And while you're labeling that, this is pretty cool because basically the device itself just started uploading. How many frames does it upload? Because I saw it uploading images. It's not uploading every single frame.
No, we sample some frames. And actually the code for this is available on GitHub, so
cool.
You can go and try it yourself. And using a variety of devices, a bunch of IoT devices are supported.
Fantastic. So we'll put a link below, obviously. And so now what you're doing is you're basically saying there's a truck.
That's right.
Okay.
And now I'm going to grab the rest of these and say that's a negative example. So there's no truck here. And this is a bit of a, you know, it's a bit of a toy classifier, both literally and, you know, we're not doing too many images. Generally, when you actually kind of build something like this, it takes a couple iterations to kind of get a really high quality model, but it's much faster than you might think.
Sure.
So I'm going to hit train here. We're going to do a quick training. And so now in Custom Vision Service, we are going to kind of go and train a classifier. So this should take, you know, a minute or two.
That's okay. When I saw, because I just was doing something similar today, believe it or not. Mm-hmm. And as I was looking at it, I saw that there was an advanced training mode that I hadn't seen before. Why don't you tell us about that?
Absolutely. So we released advanced training a couple of months ago. And basically, in advanced training, we are doing some experimentation. And so, you know, kind of quick training, we have some very default parameters. But if you have a lot of images or you kind of need a really kind of like high accuracy result, it's usually useful actually to kind of start to do advanced training. We'll experiment with things like augmentation parameters, so like rotation, scaling, solarization, et cetera, et cetera. We're also training kind of more layers of the network.
I see. The other question is, and I get this asked a lot, and I figure I'd ask the expert, how many images per class, like as a rule, I know it depends, but as a rule of thumb, like if you're like saying two images, obviously it's not two per class. What is the size?
Sure. You know, it is really problem dependent.
Yeah.
You know, every problem is really different. What I usually tell people is, what you really want to do is you want to start prototyping as quickly as you can, right? Okay. The easiest way to understand like how your models are performing are actually to kind of test them in the real world environmental conditions. You know, we've had customers who have built classifiers and they work great, and then suddenly it rains and they're like, okay, well, I need a little more data now. But I usually say, you know, start with like 50-ish. It's enough to start getting like your device sitting somewhere capturing frames. And then we make it really easy to iteratively improve your classifier, label a bunch more data. The data that comes in then, you're using to improve that that model.
And that's per class?
That's right. So 50 per class, but really to kind of start prototyping.
Oh. All right, so this trained.
That's trained, yeah. And so I'm actually going to run back here. So what happened kind of in the background when we were chatting is that not only did this train, but we downloaded the model. We downloaded an ONNX model running on this device. So this device is kind of runs, I think, Windows IoT Core. We have ONNX running on it. And so now the inferences are actually happening on this device. So on this Dragon board, we are running our model to see, okay, is there a truck in the scene? What you're seeing here is that after we run a prediction, the results are sent back kind of as an event to Azure IoT Hub, which is really nice because it lets you kind of generate analytics and understand kind of what's going on,
right.
Hook into things like Logic Apps or Power BI, kind of really whatever you want. But we're kind of running this on device, and we're not seeing our truck because it's not in frame. So what I'm going to do here is put this in frame, and there you can see, there we go. So now with like fairly high confidence, we see our truck. So it's a bit of a toy. We're a little bit overfitting here,
but that's how easy. This is pretty cool because I've been trying to figure out a way to make sure my kids stay in bed at night, and I could totally just like, this isn't creepy, right? Put an IoT device in there and be like, lay down, you know?
So it's... I'm not going to comment on if it's creepy, but it is probably a very good way to, I think, even get your kids kind of, you know, like it's so simple to be able to kind of to do this. They can help out no matter the age. They want to label the data or they want to actually, you know, get into the code and see what's going on. It's definitely just a really fun way to get started, and it's really practical. You know, we have lots of customers that are building these visual alerts.
And I made like kind of a silly, but obviously there's, for example, in manufacturing situations or, for example, and this, I kid you not, I had an assignment in Kenya and they wanted to build something that said, is the fence broken? Because if the lions get out, and that's really easy to do with this. So the code's all available, obviously?
Absolutely, you can download it on GitHub.
Fantastic, we'll put them in the links below. This is cool. I'm gonna move the truck away to see if it still works.
There it is.
Look at that, it doesn't know. I'm trying to trick it now.
And this is a real, you know, we have a real customer actually who literally does, is there a trucker car on the work site, right? They kind of do construction. All they wanna know is like, can they track the number of trucks that have kind of like gone in a certain area?
Holy cow.
Very simple.
You could also build this as a like a parking lot virtual attendant that says space 225 is available or not available.
It is highly flexible. And I think the ability to do stuff on the edge makes it really exciting because you're not having to kind of worry about like your network connectivity in an area. Like we're just setting these events up.
Fantastic. This has been awesome. Anna, thanks so much for sharing. We've been learning all about how to use custom vision and visual alerts all on these IoT devices. Thank you so much.
Thanks
so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.